Let me tell you about my knife. I'm perfectly happy to tell you about my knife. Hell, all I want to do is sit at the head of this long table, tell you about my knife, then fall asleep. Last night, I dreamt about my knife. I was holding it in my bare hand. It shone in the light that left a star we call the sun. It blazed for a few seconds in space, then hit my eye. I blinked. That made me want to hold my knife even tighter. Light. Moment. I read Skyler's poem, A Stone Knife. And in that poem, he described this knife that Kenward Elmsley gave him. I thought, I want to describe my knife too. So I am. So let me tell you about my knife. A poem can be anything. I know you don't know what my knife looks like yet, but you have a good sense of it already, don't you? The way the light hits tells you something about its sharpness, what it means to me. Maybe you'll begin to understand what it would be like if I lost it, how much that would hurt, how deep that wound would go, like flexing my kegel muscles on a gravestone, like staring at a lover while they sleep. But you know other things, don't you? What about the porcelain handle? What about the little floral inlay on the bolster? What about the rivets that look at you like a reptile's Jesus eyes that follow you along the room? Like eyes that give you shivers so you leave, that haunt you like a haunted mansion. Do you lay crushed garlic upon its steel spine? When you grasp the scales, do you think of me? I want to burst all over. You know, my knife is under my expensive cooling massage pillow. You know, I like its potential for opening letters. I think about opening letters when I look at you. I turn it over and over in my hand with only the moonlight jabbing a waxy curse across my temples through blinds. A pearl spins on the table. A man in a top hat serenades me. Let me tell you about my knife. A dove throws dice across a lighted mirror. My gloved hand holds an unopened oyster. My other hand holds my knife. An oyster drops a pearl onto the edge of the blade. A soft interior begs for mignonette. My first boyfriend gave me a Swiss Army knife on my birthday after we made out in the family bathroom at the Prudential Center. We were teens, first love. I take it out of my jewelry box every night to play with it. I brought it to college. Now he is a professor in California, and I'm in bed writing and thinking about my knife. A different knife. Tough love. My Nana had an electric knife that carved roast beef. I thought of it more like a saw. It's hacking cut through holiday caroling. It's motor louder than any laughter. I was never allowed here that night. My mama has a knife that she treats like a celebrity that no one can stand. No one trusts this knife in a room alone, and no one has been seen in the same room as her knife. I've never seen her sharpen it, but I know its name, Big Billy, same as her brother. Skyler's knife opened letters, and that's something I never do. I cut bread into slices for you. I stab perfectly good shirts into rags. I turn it over and over, protecting my bank account, wearing an elegant costume, unfurling myself open into bedtime. I turn it over and over in my hand. Sometimes I fall asleep with my knife in my hand, but usually I store it under my mattress, between my mattress and the box spring. This keeps me alert. Sometimes I pass the knife from hand to hand. This keeps me safe from all the bother of the world, all the men who spiral open before me like plated ham. Thank you.